better than getting your mates around a table and sharing some amazing food. What about jumping into the kitchen together? Well, Chef Joel Bickford from the Gantry in Sydney has done just that. He's put together a menu with all of his best chef mates, including James Viles from Biota Dining, and they're both here to join us this morning to talk us through some of these gorgeous meals. Fellas, welcome, welcome. First of all, what are we making today?
We're going to look at two dishes today. We have our five-course degustation running at the restaurant now, this promotion for Oz Harvest, mm-hmm. and we're looking at the first two courses today, which is a smoked mackerel dish using some nice local mackerel from Newcastle. So Troy, this is Troy from Newcastle who did this dish.
Right, not the fish's name. Troy's not
the fish. No, Troy is not the fish.
Good name for fish, naming though. The mackerel these days.
Pretty close to our ingredients, but not that close. But
and what's James doing over there?
James is going to do a dish of just some little potatoes out of Robertson in the Southern Highlands with some nice corn which has been smoked. And then just a little sheep's yogurt and finish with some nice truffle from the Snowy Mountains.
This truffle, what do you think this looks like, Mike?
Well, I think it looks like my grandmother's old sponge on the side of the sink in the laundry, you know?
Up to 6 months.
You remember that old one that was always like hard, does it?
Yes.
It's a bit more expensive.
You put it in the wash every 6 months. $300 for this tiny piece of truffle.
Yeah, you're looking around, you know, $2+ a gram, so.
Wow.
You know, yeah. Depends on the sizes vary and where they come from.
It's so good though, truffle, yeah, isn't it? No.
after what you just said, don't smell anything.
It's not quite like the new baby.
No. Well, now, talk to us about why you're putting this wonderful dinner together.
Basically, it was just an initiative that I wanted to do because, you know, Oz Harvest is a charity that really supports food rescue and of saving like surplus food in the industry, basically. So,
because so much food in the hospitality industry can actually go to waste if it's not used properly, right?
Yeah,
which is just so infuriating when you consider that so many Australians in this first world country don't get dinner.
No, that's right. And all the chefs involved have been affiliated with Oz Harvest in certain ways when they do their initiatives. So we just wanted to put together and get a group of my friends and see what we can do and raise a bit more money, mm-hmm. and you know, let people that can afford it come out.
I'm just laughing at Mike. How are you going over there with the tatey?
I know, cook. Can you tell?
It's a good stir. It's better to go anti-clockwise, actually.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
I don't read a clock either. So anyway, hey, James, tell me, like, I mean, your beautiful restaurant's up in Barrel, Southern Highlands,
yep.
Beautiful part. Do you use a lot of local produce for cooking?
Pretty much
there?
Everything. Yeah.
Everything up
yeah,
there?
Yeah, everything is. And it changes every couple of weeks as well.
You know, does it?
Yeah, one lady will bring in some figs 1 week, not this time of year. Mandarins 1 week, and we'll use them all up until she's got no more left, and then we'll change to something else. So
I guess that explains why when I drive through Barrow, all the cows look really nervous.
Yeah. Use those up till there's nothing left as well.
They do.
So Joel, do you need to cook anything, or is it more a case of assembling now?
Yeah, pretty much. Everything's pretty much done on this one. This is the first course that we'll be offered.
So you've got a mackerel mousse.
We've got a mackerel mousse, and little flaked mackerel. It's been smoked twice. Some nice little wild oxalis flowers. A smoked mackerel crumb made from the bones of the fish, mm-hmm. and some little Averiga caviar and some compressed
apple. So not something you'd whip up at home for the kids, but something, you know, you'd go out for a nice
something
romantic
dinner. Something a little bit special, some quite simple ingredients, but just, you know, executed in the way that you probably wouldn't do at home. So mm-hmm. that's the whole idea, to bring people out and then so they can help contribute to Oz
Harvest.
Yeah,
and have an experience.
Yeah, definitely.
So this truffle, is this going to be grated over something?
Yeah. We'll can you do the honour? Can you
shave? Sure.
Just down to the knuckles, so until there's nothing left.
Stop when you hit
the
knuckles?
Yeah, very different. It's very different to my grater at home.
So, yeah, just...
It's very sharp.
Yes. Is it?
That's it.
Just go nuts.
Yeah, you want lots of truffle.
It's like $30 there. I don't know about this.
Yeah, keep going. It's Joel's truffle.
Charging it to Charlton.
Well, that's enough then.
So just go bang, 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 bang. Yeah, that's it.
Run that seems like a waste.
No.
Oh, wow. So what's in this? Potatoes?
So potatoes, corn juice. So corn that's been juiced.
Yep.
Truffle and sheep's milk yogurt.
Mm. Sheep's milk yogurt. Should we have a taste of this? This looks amazing. Yeah. And that would be served with this on the plate?
You can do that.
Okay.
Can we do something else as well with it?
Yeah, you just eat it. Stir it, man.
Susie, our resident pescatarian, is coming in to try the mackerel mousse.
I am. Pescatarian always worries me. It sounds far too religious for
me. It does a little bit, doesn't it?
I like to call myself a vegaquarian.
Oh,
a vegaquarian.
Vegaquarian.
Grab one of those little flowers too. They've got a nice citrus
really?
Sort of taste.
So. And then some of this as well.
Yeah, sure. Get in there.
Oh, I feel...
So the crumb is made from the bones of the mackerel, which is smoked and fried and dried. And
I think we should encourage more mackerel to smoke. Because that is spectacular.
They are very fancy potatoes.
Oh, my goodness. May I dip in
now,
there
if you
well?
Would like to try these amazing dishes and more, you can head to thegantry.com.au. It's all part of the July menu for Friends of the Gantry. Joel and James, thanks, guys, for joining us this morning. What a great call.